Hello and welcome to our channel. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use Calibre Interactive to back-annotate SmartFill as a reference in your Virtuoso design block. Typical fill flows may add fill shapes into the block layout as primitive shapes intermingled with your layout polygons, which can sometimes make it difficult to work with. Another alternative is to place the fill shapes for your block into a cell and place a reference to the fill cell in your design. This is precisely what the Calibre Place in Cell Fill Flow was designed to do. Using Calibre Interactive, we can configure the fill back annotation to output to a new cell name and have it automatically placed in the cell. First, I'll run Calibre SmartFill using the Calibre Interactive I launched from my Virtuoso layout. In the transcript of this run, we can see 435 fill shapes generated as output. These fill shapes are currently written to an OASIS file that I can open in Calibre Design Riv so we can see the fill output. The output fill top cell is prefixed with FILL underscore so that I don't accidentally overwrite my design layout cell named adder underscore 4 when I add it to my open access database. We can also see that the SmartFill deck generated only M2 fill on layer number 52 with layer name MT2 underscore fill. To back annotate this to Virtuoso, I must provide a mapping file for each layer I import as fill. In this fill.layermap file, I have defined the cadence Virtuoso layer name MT2 underscore fill and layer purpose fill as layer number 52 data type 0. With the OASIS fill and map file on disk, I can go to the Calibre Interactive triggers page to define a post execution trigger to run our back annotation utility. This will import the OASIS fill to the Virtuoso open access database. The trigger will use parameter substitution, which is listed at the bottom of this panel. The library, cell and view we launched the fill job on is defined by %i, %l, and %v, which you can see in the table below. The dash design option defines the destination cell to import our fill shapes. In this case, we want to create a new fill cell, so we add fill underscore in front of %l so we don't overwrite our design layout. Next, specify dash oasis and the fill.oasis file output from the smart fill run. Use the top cell option to define the name of the top cell in fill.oasis. Remember, it had a FILL underscore prefix, so we prefix %l again here to match. The dash layer map option specifies the fill mapping file we viewed earlier. Next, we define where we want to place the fill cell, which we just defined using the place in cell option. We want to insert the placement of the fill cell in the Virtuoso design we launched Calibre Interactive from. So here, we specify that as %my, %l, and %v. The last option defines a cell prefix if you have a hierarchical fill database to import. Our data doesn't, so that doesn't impact this example. The block must be closed for edits since we want to insert the fill cell, so I closed my Virtuoso window. Now I can rerun the smart fill job. This time, we can see the information about the trigger running at the bottom of the Calibre Interactive window. If I reopen the layout in Virtuoso, we can select the fill reference. Now I can save my configuration as a run set, and every time I run SmartFill, my fill will be updated for my block. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have a suggestion for a new video, please comment below. Thanks for watching.